In this lesson, we're going to take a look at the major types of tissues that make up the human body. Now, whether we are looking at the human body or other living organisms, it can generally be broken down into four major types of tissues. So whether we're looking at a bird or a frog, it always keeps coming back to these same four types of tissues. Now, we want to refresh our memory on the definition of a tissue, and a tissue is when specialized cells work together to perform a common function. So when you have a lot of the same type of cells working together to perform a job, that is when you have a tissue. So the four main types of tissues that we're going to be looking at are the connective, epithelial, muscle, and nervous. We'll take a look at each one in detail throughout this lesson. Let's start with connective tissue. The connective tissue has a wide variety of different types of tissue that fall into this category, so therefore it has a lot of jobs or functions. So its main jobs are to strengthen, support, or connect cells and different tissues to each other. So some of the main examples include bone, blood, and fat. So if we take a look at bone, blood, fat, and another type, loose connective tissue, which are ligaments in our body, we notice that they all have slightly different shapes because they have slightly different jobs. But if we look at them all, one key thing that we can notice about all of them is all of them kind of have a random shape to them and kind of a loose patterning amongst them. They're not all very neat and organized. The next type of tissue is epithelial tissue. Now, epithelial tissue's job is to cover external and internal body surfaces. So externally, it would be the skin on your hands protecting you from the outside, or internally, it covers all of your different organs. So it covers your lungs, covers your heart, and its job is for protection. So the main example that we will put down would be our skin. Now, if we look at its shape of all the cells in that tissue, they are kind of randomly shaped, but all kind of oval. They're relatively flat, and they're really tight together because their job is to protect, so you don't want spaces in between because otherwise things could get through that could harm us. Muscle tissue is the third type of tissue that we will look at. Its job or main function is to allow body parts to move, exert forces, or to change shape. So by moving, right, you might move your arm, you might move your leg, exerting a force. Now you might need to push something along or move something, like your heart, it pumps the blood, or your intestines keep the food moving through. Or maybe the muscles are needed to change shape, right, to make you smile, make you blink. Now within muscle tissue, we have three main types of tissue. We have smooth muscle tissue, cardiac, and skeletal. Now smooth muscle tissue forms our organs, so our stomach, our intestines. And the key thing here is it's involuntarily controlled, which means we don't have to think about it, right? You don't have to sit there after lunch and tell your stomach, squish, squeeze, turn, move. It does it involuntarily. So all smooth muscles work that way. Cardiac muscle, on the other hand, makes up the heart, and it's only found in the heart. It is also involuntarily controlled. We don't have to tell our heart to beat. It beats all on its own. Skeletal muscle tissue is found on any muscles that move our bones or are connected to our skeleton. Now, if you were looking through a microscope, a way to tell these types of tissues apart is the way that they're patterned. So skeletal are all long and skinny and organized in bundles. Smooth aren't quite as long and skinny, and you tend to see more of them squished together. And cardiac have a lot of branches to them. Skeletal and cardiac also have what are called striations or stripes on them, where smooth does not. The fourth and last type of tissue that we'll look at is nervous tissue. Its job is to send and receive information. So that can be taking in information from the outside, letting you know that it's cold, sending a message to your brain so that your brain can do something about it. Whether that is you get up and you go get a sweater, maybe you start shivering, but it allows you to process the information, okay? Or it could be your stomach telling a message to your brain that you're hungry. So any of the quick messaging that happens in our body is through nervous tissue. So example of where we'd find that tissue would be in our brain or our spinal cord.